Pinas mo lang ito sa eskinita.
Ay, hindi, kasi mayroon akong kausap na doctor, pakilala ko sa inyo. Napakaganda, oh, di ba? Napakatangkad, oh. Parang pang-beauty queen. Doktora Maria Corazon, di ba? Maria Corazon de Jesus.
Sige po, upo muna po kayo bago tumayo.
Dito pala. Ah, okay. Yan.
Yan, pwede na.
And then si Doc kasi isa siyang perinatologist, head of nutrition committee ng Department of Obstetrics and Gynecology. Doc, ano muna yung perinatologist?
Oo. Yeah. A perinatologist is a specialist in maternal fetal medicine. Okay. So in other words, we take care of patients who have high risk conditions, like if they have medical problems. At the same time, we also help the general obstetricians to manage their high-risk patients. Yun. And I am a member of the nutrition committee of the Asian Hospital and Medical Center.
Alright, so this month is the Breastfeeding Awareness Month. No? So right now, we're going to talk about the supplements we need for the breastfeeding mothers.
Yeah.
Ano po ba yun?
Okay, before anything else, I would first like to thank our program, Good Morning Kuya, for inviting us here in to be able to reach the pregnant patients as well as the lactating mothers. Now, this is a very important topic, breastfeeding. And today I have been given the task to answer questions about supplements. So, if we say supplements, pwede akong mag-English. Pagka we say supplements, our patients think that it's only about vitamins and minerals. It's actually not only that. Okay, when we say supplements, first of all, I tell my patients that for successful breastfeeding, their commitment to breastfeed, their dedication to breastfeed, their passion to breastfeed should start from the moment they plan their pregnancy. Okay? Because if you are healthy during or even before you're pregnant, then you're healthy throughout your pregnancy. This is going to ensure a healthy baby, a healthy mother that will be able to sustain their babies to breastfeed for at least 6 months. And they can even extend up to 1 year or 2 years.
Makes sense talaga. Dapat committed ka eh, di ba? Mabigyan ng ang anak mo ng inyong gatas. Pero yun nga, aside sa nabanggit nyo, mami, mga supplements, mga vitamins and minerals na iniinom na during yung mga prenatal care na tinatawag. What are the other things that you need to do as a mom para po makapagbigay kayo ng gatas sa inyong anak?
Okay. First of all, after delivering our babies, okay, when we already initiated the breastfeeding, okay, we want the mothers to be aware na meron silang dagdag na calorie intake. Okay?
Yeah.
So hindi sila dapat mag-isip na kailangan mag-reduce na ako to get back to my weight. That weight is physiologic. It will gradually decrease even if you do not go on a diet.
Sabi nga nila, mas maganda pa daw ang baka mas mabilis ang pagbalik mo sa normal body mo when you breastfeed.
Yes. Actually, during pregnancy, we have added 300 calories. But in our daily intake, but during lactation, that increases to 500. During lactation, our mommies, the body is working. Okay? So that the body is really exerting effort, increases its metabolism. So we need another 500 calories per day.
May nabasa nga akong isang article, parang sinasabi doon na 2,200 calories a day for mom is not enough kasi you will be needing vitamins such as magnesium, yung calcium mo, yung zinc mo.
Yes.
So how true is that na more than 2,200 yung intake na kailangan mo?
Okay, hindi naman. We calculate it by looking at getting your ideal body weight, your height, your activity, your work, yun. So for example, if you are 5'5", or you are 140 pounds and you're active. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So we give you additional.
Yes.
From your supposed to be your intake is supposed to be 2000 calories.
We so add plus 5 and 5.
Mm-hmm. But for you, for example, you're active, your ideal body weight is 100 or 105, no? If you are 5'1", mm-hmm. then we add a little, we add 500 and we will you will be taking then 1,600 calories.
Mm-hmm. So, depende rin talaga depende yan dun sa tao.
Height, sa weight, sa BMI, sa ideal body weight mm-hmm. ni mommy.
Okay. Gusto ko lang itanong Doc din, ano, pwede ba yung, halimbawa kasi, kunyari, babalik na siya sa pagtatrabaho, di ba? So, we all know na pwede naman na mag-stock ng breast milk ng mommy, di ba? Pero pwede din ba niya ihalo at the same time yung formula niya?
Oo. So, before that, we encourage muna our patients. Di ba, they go on leave. Di ba, they are our working mothers are entitled to 60 days,
yes,
right? 60 days,
maternity leave.
And during that time, during the first months of the baby, mm-hmm. ang kailangan ni baby, siguro mga 2 ounces milk, mm-hmm. ganon. And the mommy has plenty of milk, mm-hmm. okay? So, so this is the time that they can store. So, mm-hmm. mag-store sila. So, at least para pagka umalis na si mommy, mag-work na si mommy after 2 months, meron siya pang stock.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm.
So, the ideal sustenance or nourishment for the baby is breast milk for the first 6 months.
Okay.
And then after 6 months, this baby's already, solids are introduced na. Mm-hmm. Yun. So, pagka na-introduce na yung solids kay baby, and the mommy is already in the
back to work,
mm-hmm. na baka kulang na yung kanyang supply, then probably she can ask her obstetrician to is it already okay to supplement formula.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so pagdating niya sa bahay, pwede siyang mag-breastfeed, pwede pa rin siyang mm-hmm. mag-store habang nandun siya sa ano sa work siya, mm-hmm. work niya, pero minsan kulang.
Mm-hmm.
Kulang na. So if the baby is
parang fuzzy, tumatakaw na siya,
baka kulang yung milk aside from the solids na na-introduce. Mm. Ganon.
So, Doc, before we let you go, ano po ba yung pinaka-advice na mabibigay nyo sa mga moms-to-be para sa mga gusto nilang mag-breastfeed?
Okay. So, as I said kanina, which is I want this to be imparted to all, especially to the rural and to the urban poor, no? I want to reach them because, as I said, the moment you start planning a pregnancy,
mm-hmm.
okay, that should be the start of the future planning mm-hmm. for a nutrition, for a healthy, healthy body, for a healthy mommy, and for a healthy baby.
Mm-hmm. Yun.
And then to be able to successfully breastfeed. Mm-hmm. So, aside from that calorie intake, since she mentioned about vitamins kanina, no? If we have rich, our diet is good.
No need for vitamins.
Of protein, vegetables, mineral, and ano, we can get these vitamins from
the food.
Yes, mm-hmm. but some essential minerals like calcium, we have to supplement.
Yes,
it's very important to supplement with calcium.
Mm-hmm.
It's very important to supplement with. Vitamin B, mm-hmm. no? For added energy, and we have lots of vitamin D. Okay, iron, since ang buntis ay ang nanganak ay hindi pa nagme-menstruate. So kung hindi ka naman anemic during pregnancy, then iron is all right. But if you are anemic during pregnancy, then you have to take iron supplements. Fluid is very important because we produce mga 800 cc of milk every day. Mm-hmm. So, just imagine how much the fluid that we lose during
breastfeeding.
Mm-hmm. So, ang mommy is supposed to increase her fluid intake.
Hydrate. Maraming salamat po sa inyo, Doktora Maria Corazon de Jesus ng Asian Hospital sa pagiging one of the advocates po ng breastfeeding.
Thank you, Doc.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us. Mm-hmm.